In this introductory tutorial to SolidWorks, we're going to create this easy-to-make part right here. Before we get started, I want you to notice a couple different things. This is a really basic part, but it has some interesting features. When you're sketching a part in SolidWorks, you always want to start by sketching the face that has the most information. If we look at this part, we can see that it has a hole in the middle, it has a slot down here, and it has a smooth edge that transitions to an arch. If we looked at it from the side, we'd see that it also has a step. In SolidWorks, you want to keep sketches as simple as possible, but at the same time, you want to start with the generic shape of the part. I've also already created a drawing of this part, and we can take a look at that for dimensions. But let's go ahead and start a new part, and we'll copy this part again. When you make a drawing, the first thing you want to do is to make sure you're in the units that you want to be in. You access units by clicking on System Options and then go to Document Properties and click on Units, and we're in inch pound second, which is what we want to be in. And again, that's found up here in the Options menu. Next, you need to open a sketch on a plane. So let's go ahead and select the top plane. You'll see a flyout menu with a new sketch icon. If you click on that, we'll be brought around to be perpendicular to this sketch. Notice that there's now two red arrows. This is called the origin, and you want the origin to be part of your sketch somehow. So I'm going to grab the line tool from the command manager, and I'm going to come down and I draw my first line to be the approximate length I want. I know the part's going to be about 2 inches long in this direction. It's going to come across and then it's going to come up, and I now need to draw an arc. There's a trick in SolidWorks that you can transition straight from a line command to an arc command by returning back to the endpoint, and then it will transition to an arc, and that's what I want to do. And it will transition right back to a line for the next command, and I can come across and then come to here. I'm going to do that trick again to get another arc. It's very nice. I don't have to click any buttons. And now I've completed my contour. I can also grab the circle tool and put in the circle that's going to be in the middle. Okay, so my sketch now looks roughly like the other sketch, the outline of the original part. So I'm going to go back and get some dimensions so that I can dimension it. Looks like it's 2.75 inches to the center of this line to the edge, and the radius of that big guy is 0.8. I'll also notice that it's 0.88 to the center of this, and 0.63 on an edge. So if I come back, I can go ahead and dimension my part by clicking on Smart Dimension. I'll grab here and then up here and put in that dimension of 2.75. I'll do the same down here on this line, 2.75. Next, I'm going to dimension this to have a radius of 0.88. Okay, this leg here was 0.63, and the distance between this guy and this guy was another 0.88. Okay, and I need to go back to my drawing to look up the value of those center circles. Looks like we have a diameter 0.63, and this guy has a radius of 0.25, so a diameter of 0.5. Oopsies. You'll notice when I tried to add this dimension and I click, everything turns yellow. This dimension would overdefine the part, so I don't want to add it. What I want to do is figure out what else I need to do in this case. So if I grab anywhere that's blue is undefined. So I can go ahead and grab this circle and see what's undefined about it. I need to get out of my dimension command here, but if I grab that center point, you can see I can move it back and forth. So I need to get the dimension for the length of the slot. And I can do that by clicking back and taking a look here and seeing it's a slot depth of 0.5 inches. So I can transition back to my drawing and add that dimension by clicking on the center of the circle and the edge. And we'll add that 0.5. And I'm done. Now I have the outline of my drawing, and I'm going to go ahead and extrude that. Let's see how tall this part is. It looks like the part is 1 inch tall and then has a step at half an inch that's 1.75 inches away. Okay, so we can go back to our part and click on Features, Extrude. Okay, and I'm going to want to extrude this 1 inch, so I can change that in the Property Manager. And I'll go ahead and click on the checkbox to accept that. Now remember, there's a step in this part. I can make that step either by drawing a rectangle on this face or on this face. Either way works, but if you click on this face, the flyout menu has a sketch option, so I'm going to go ahead and open that sketch option, and then I'll click my rectangle tool, grab the corner, drag across, and then dimension this. The step that I need to cut away is half of an inch, and it was 1.75 inches long, so I can change that to be 1.75. And then I will cut that material away by doing extrude cut. Notice that my cut is only going halfway through, so I could change my value here, or I could change the end condition by clicking where it says blind and say through all, and that will cut all the way through the part. Okay, now I've successfully created a part here that looks exactly like my other part. And the main purpose of this lesson was to talk about modeling strategy. When you model something, you want to go ahead and draw the outline as close as possible, dimension it, and then extrude it.